Is the Institute spying on your home? Read the public to find out.
Watch your back. The Institute could be right behind you.
Hey, Nat.
Hey, mister. That interview you did with Piper is really selling. Here's your free copy.
Hairstyles from across the Commonwealth.
Hey.
Just let me know.
Hey.
Point the way.
Hey, Piper.
Hey, here. Something to keep you sharp. Always worked for me.
Your thoughts?
Never thought a reporter could consider themselves a success until someone threatened their life. Me? I'm very successful.
That's all.
Okay.
You there. We need to talk.
Is there a problem?
The problem is that I've learned that you killed my son, Nelson. Is this true?
What makes you think I killed him?
Morosky says so. One of his guys saw you do it. Murdered him in cold blood. I dare you to deny it to my face. Did you do it?
Yes, it's true. I killed him.
You son of a bitch! At least tell me one thing. Why did you do it?
I'm sorry he's dead. Things just got out of hand.
You're sorry? Tell that to my son! This isn't over. This isn't over!
Hey, I'll be right back.
Hey, you're in the paper, right? You're 200 years old. Looking pretty good for your age, huh?
Hey there, mister.
Excuse me, you got a moment? Do you feel like Diamond City leadership has been responsive to your concerns? Are they really listening?
I don't want to get into this again, Piper. Can you just bother someone else?
Yeah, sure. Thanks for stopping this time.
You're that vault dweller from the paper. Nice pip boy.
Jeez, pal. I like guns, too. But you think you might be overcompensating there?
All you outsiders wear such funny clothes?
Doctor?
This better be an emergency.
Actually, I need some supplies for the road.
I suppose I could spare some stimpaks.
Excuse me, Dr. Sun?
What?
Yeah, so anyway, Dr. Sun, I got a problem.
Want to do something fun?
Run the bases. Trust me. What?
Radiation poisoning is a common ailment, but we can cure just about anything.
Shopping at night? Diamond City surplus is always...
Officer?
You watch your step. Got my eye on you. Don't know you, Scabber.
I hear you've been asking questions around town. What? Diamond City's got two private dicks now?
I want to be left alone.
Need the trade? We're always open. Everyone else may be closed, but Diamond City Surplus is open 24 hours a day.
Let's see what you have.
Seen better days, hasn't it?
Nat.
You won't believe what's in the next issue. Just you wait. You can't stop the press.
Hey, Nat.
Ain't got nothing better to do?
Can't believe I'm posted outside the wall. Who the heck did I piss off?
Please help! She's hurt! Hurry! She's in here! Please help!
Back here! Hurry! Harris!
I told you to bring them in through the basement! Shut up! They're headed this way now. Be ready! It's taking so long. I don't know. Maybe you should go check it out.
You don't think I will?
I'm tired of sitting on my ass anyway.
What's the point of hiding back here? Why the hell don't we just shoot them in the head the second they step through the door?
Who?
What the?
Being on the move again. Fewer paper cuts than back home. may be constantly trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for excitement. Good luck finding anything in here.
Won't be able to pick this.
problem there, Blue.
Hey, ain't no shame in taking the occasional camp.
Solomon can hook you up.
Beer in my slippers after this shift. That's all I ask.
Every piece in here is worth what I charge for it. No arguments.
I'll take a look, sure.
Just don't call it junk.
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use for it.
Don't walk outside the wall undefended. High quality protection for sale.
You're back. You find that paint?
Wasn't easy, but I found some. Yeah.
Now that's damn fine news. Why don't you go ahead and paint the first stroke? Let's see how the shade matches up.
Abbott.
That's a good shade of green. The wall sure seems happy with it.
You think that's enough paint to last you?
Should be enough for a good coat or two. That'll have to do for now. There's your payment, and a little bonus for getting the right shade of green. Don't do anything with it I wouldn't do.
I'm glad we did this. The wall is important to a lot of people here, Blue.
Piper.
Talk to me.
Is everything all right between us, Piper?
I guess I'm still on the fence. Show me you want to make lives better out here. Then we'll talk.
That's all.
Okay.
Broke up with my girl. She kept the cap off the toothpaste. Know who does that? A synth.
Who's talking about a new gun? I can sell you a properly machined grip at a
Coca-Cola. Nuka-Cola.
You can install it yourself.
Hmm. Not a bad idea.
Hey, Sheffield.
Maybe next time.
So thirsty. Nuka-Cola.
You want a soda? Is that it?
Dugout Inn usually has some, but I can't go there. Can't be around booze. Doctor says I can't drink that.
Here you go.
Ah, thank you. Thank you.
The hub of trade for all Diamond City right here.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
Really? You mean it?
What do you say?
Okay. Maybe this will be a fresh start.
Always on good behavior, aren't you?
Didn't realize I had been.
So this is you not even trying, huh? I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered. Of course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far. I mean, look at Diamond City, a place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change? It's enough to make me want to hang up my hat some days.
Is Diamond City really in danger? It's not like there's raiders pounding on the gate.
Are you kidding me? There is a very real chance the city leadership has been infiltrated by an Institute synth. A synth under the control of an organization widely known to kidnap or murder anyone that stands up to them. I'd take raiders at the gate any day of the week over that. Of course, making sure folks are actually listening. That's a battle in itself.
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
Huh, no kidding. But people, they deserve to know the truth. Always on good behavior, aren't you?
I try to be.
Seems like you're doing better than trying. I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered. Of course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far. I mean, look at Diamond City. A place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change? It's enough to make me want to hang up my hat some days.
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
Huh, no kidding. But people, sure, it can be scary. Knowing a night doesn't go by, I'm not afraid some Institute drone will decide today's the day to pay old Piper and family a visit. But it's worth it, because I know the truth. That's what protects us.
Scared, huh? Could have fooled me.
I'm pushy, not crazy. Honestly, these days, I'm more scared for my sister. I don't know what I'd do if something happened to her. But I'm not the only one with something to lose. That's why people deserve to know what's out there, good or bad.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. How can you protect you and yours if you don't know what you're facing?
Exactly. Most folks, though, they'd prefer a comforting lie. Not me. I've seen firsthand what the truth can do. My sister and I, we grew up way out in the Commonwealth. Tiny little settlement. Our dad, he was part of the local militia. Keeping the raiders off our backs and the Mirelurks out of our latrines, as he'd describe it. Well, one day, our dad turns up dead. His captain, asshole named Mayburn, claims raiders must have gotten him on watch. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. Turns out, the captain, he'd sold out. Thought he wasn't getting paid enough to babysit the town. He was gonna leave the gates open one night, let a group of raiders sack the place and take a cut of the profits. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. I tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. So, I papered the entire town in posters. Wanted for gross dereliction of duty, Captain Mayburn. The mayor sure wanted to talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed. Always on good behavior, aren't you?
I try to be.
Seems like I... Of course. I mean...
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
Sure. Because I know...
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more.
Exactly. I've seen our dad. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. He was gonna leave the gates open one night. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. I tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. The mayor sure wanted to talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed.
What happened after that?
We made do. Sis was still pretty young at the time, and Mom was out of the picture. So we got by on the kindness of others for a while. Eventually, I saved up enough to book us both passage with the caravan, and then we moved on up to the big city. Called it home ever since.
Piper, you saved those people.
No. Those people saved themselves. Because they knew the truth. But hey, I'm sorry if I've been rambling. I just get fired up sometimes. It's just nice to talk to someone who actually seems to get it, you know? So, should we head out?
We can talk about guns, or maybe you want to consider something more up close and personal.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Everything hand-tooled.
Nice piece you got there. Just keep it holster.
Who needs a haircut? Everyone needs a haircut. Step up.
Read the public and be prepared.
We got purified water inside the city. Best drink in the Commonwealth.
Says on a radio. My name is Rex Goodman. I'm being held prisoner on the top of Trinity Tower. I think the super mutants plan on eating me soon. I'm setting this to repeat. Oh, shit! Gotta sign off. One of the super mutants is coming! Help, or Mayday, or whatever it is one says on a radio. My name is Rex Goodman. I'm being held prisoner on the top of...
Blue, we're not alone here.
Who's there? Let's do this.
Free for the taking.
Nothing to see here.
Thank you.
show them. Nothing there now. Huh?
It's all.
We're gonna dance? Let's dance. Should've backed down.
Hey.
What you got for me?
Piper.
You look like you could use a pick-me-up.
Is everything all right between us, Piper?
It's hard to say at the moment. I think I need you to show me you're not just out here for yourself.
Nothing else for now.
Sure.
Thank you.
walking right into Boston Commons. People don't come back from here.
Silver Shroud fans, I got an urgent mission. If you're a true fan, stop by the Memory Den and to talk to Kent Conley. The Silver Shroud needs you.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the tracks.
Yeah, wrong side of the tracks.
I can carry something if you need me to.
There's a whole bunch of you, aren't there? For now.
Where'd that little fucker go? When you turn up, you're dead.
Welcome, Patriot, to Boston Common, the start of the Freedom Trade. Feast your ears and learn more about the historic Freedom Trail. And learn the history of Boston Common.
You're a tour guide?
Error. Response not recognized.
I'm telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. We caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that bat of hers at your face until there ain't no face left.